Okay, door number 1, 2, 3, and 4. Hello? Attack! Okay, we've got goblins and either hill orcs or mountain orcs. We'll start with the goblins anyway. It's all that we can hit, but I'd rather get rid of them. We should be able to get rid of them really rather quickly and then focus on our orc friends. Oh, I didn't reload! And he's out of arrows. Damn it. And he's out of stones, I guess, too. Double damn it. Oh well. Well, actually, he's got fireballs. I'm not gonna waste the fireballs on the goblins. I'll send it here. These orcs are going to be moving up. Boom. Ow, 13 on spike. They're hill orcs. Boom. Oh, it actually hit them all. Loving it. I'm gonna keep on doing that. Grab and hit for 10. Spike it for 9. I'm gonna need to heal him. Ah! Unsuccessful. Should I wait one more? To maximize the potion? Silk's got 1. Trazric's got 1. Joe Benir's got 1, as far as potions. Not too good. We need a lot more. Calling it for 9. Okay, time to heal spike. Successful, yay! The goblins are gone. Heal the doggy. Let's focus on this one. Has 3 more fireballs. Healed. Ah, that's successful. Sucky. Opener hit for 10. Boom, nice. I hope that last one will work. Here it is. Opener hit for 9 and 6. Spike hit for 9. Gribbon for 5. Fireball! Ah! Unsuccessful, damn it. We can cast one beam of fire. Successful, 2 points. And 6. Unfortunately, we got half of us attacking. Stinks. I wish we could transfer items during combat. Jobinator hit for 5, spike hit for 9, not good. Okay, we got another Hill Orc down. Curious, actually. This is a mace. Thief cannot use. Let's see if there's something they picked up that they can use. I really don't want to use these things. The Wand of Fire, Wand of Light. Mm-mm. Wish I remembered to refill their weapon slots, or ammo slots, rather. Oh well. Six and two. Jobinir, hitting away. Can hit for small amounts and missing. At least they stop hitting Spike. 4 and 4, nice. We might be done with this one soon. Remember, they're probably weakened from the fireballs. I don't think they regenerate. Jobinator hit for 9. Gribbon for 8. Spike hit for 6. Oh! We got rid of one! Jobinator missed the target because there is no target. Here. Jobinir attack once again. Okay. The three of us attacking once again. One and two. Better than nothing. And 10, nice. And 4. Ah! One left. Move 2 of them over. Oh, he's... Yeah, I can't. He fled. Alright, that's fine. That is fine. 23 experience. Battle. Opponents. Stuff. 87 gold. some of these knives. Oh, we're full, though. But he used up a potion, so he's got one slot open. If I have any shoes, I'll drop them. What do you think? Knives get more than clubs? I don't even know. Alright, before I forget, okay, he can't carry anything now because he's got the things. The hat I'm saving for our wizard friend. Actually, what we can do here is hopefully we can give all these to Trasric. Trasric might not have any slots open. He doesn't. Well, those are his scrolls, though. I just need a slot open to give him his ammo. Here we go. Now they can attack melee again. I mean, ranged again. Okay, so Gribben has one slot open. Spike can't carry anything. That's the problem. And Jobinio's got one open. So we've got knives, we got leathers, we got torches. We can take the torches. And who's got the other one? Gribben. Now, if we really want to do this, maximize this as much as we can, which we still have more to explore. Oh, am I out of that? Can I still collect? No, I think I'm out of that. It's too late. Too late for me. It's alright. The only other thing I was going to do is going to... get that and that in one so we can get another slot. And then put the torches all to one person so we can have another slot. And that's it. Can't stack anything else. So we've been able to pick up two more leathers. That's it. But I exited out. It's too late. That's okay though. Not that big of a deal. We might need to put it for something else anyway. Because we're not done exploring. Should I rest? Oh, we can't really do that trick anymore, can we? We can rest a little bit. Can we pick up some more rations? We've got 7, 9, 9, 4. 1 and 7. Let's rest 3 times, I think. Okay, so what? 7, 7, 7, 4, 5, and 7. I'm gonna sleep at 4. Was that 3? One more. Okay, good. All right, saving. This is taking forever, guys. Hope this isn't interesting to you. Alright, where are we now? Cool! What we got? Stuff we can't carry, because we're... You hear the sound of a fuse sputtering, then there is a bang, and the area is filled with a blinding light. Hear a strange noise. Strange noise. They're blinded then. You open the lock with a pass key. In this chest you find a key. Guild key. Nice. We can't carry anything though. Is that because we're blind? Ah! Interesting. Now, even blind, he could still open that. I'm sure that's gonna affect his battle prowess. Oh, one of those herbs cure blindness? We really need to get fixed up now. One of them might be. No transfer, I want to use paralysis, poisoning, aging. I don't have anything with blindness. I'm in a separate file, I guess we're in a non-winnable state or something. Okay, we are here. So I'm guessing... final door brings us here. Bing! We are facing the magic mouth. Should know it by heart by now. Kinda do. Backing in. Just making sure. Okay. Door number 5. Hello? Where are we now? Okay, we're kind of where I expected we would be. Oh, hello. I hope they can attack. I know they're blind, but I don't know if that affects attack. You'd think it would, right? Alright, we will all attack this one. Or try to. Two fireballs, that's it? Damn it. All missing. Spike it for 13. Crap. Successful, yay. Ow. Nice. At least we got use out of both of them. Heal spike. Jobber hit for 12. Spike hit for 10. Ouch. Gribben hit for 10. Spike healed. I could do 2 beams of fire, a wall of fire, or a water hole. Try water hole. Spike it for 8. Unsuccessful. Okay. Right. Trasric is left to his sling rocks. Spike it for 11 and 2, nice. We might get rid of that one, and then he'll be alright. Gribben hit for 4. Ah, he's still standing. Well, only 2 points, but I was hoping it would take him out. For 3, now he's out, nice. Now, unfortunately, we all missed because you're all aiming at that one. Ouch. Open here for 3 and then 14. Okay, Jobaneer will tank these two. Yeah. I will move him over. Actually, is that what I meant to do? Move him over. Because Gribben is not as an effective a tank. Nowhere near close. I'll have everyone else focus on this one. Drobaneer is good enough, he can take on two. Spike might as well attack this round since he can't move yet. Oh, he hit for 12. Nice. Okay, now we'll move him over. Hit him for 3. Seven. From Gribben. Just attacking now. Nothing much to talk about, unfortunately. Gribben was hit for 4. We only have one healing potion left, so hopefully we'll only need to use one. Everyone missing. No one hit anything that round. Whole bunch of air. Someone hit something. Nothing hit. Okay, 3. And 1. And 5 on Drobaneer. On Drobaneer's work, anyway. Gribben hit for 5. Four on that orc. Come on, take out the orc. And 3. Will Drobaneer hit this round? No, he will not. Well, he will. He will miss and then hit for no damage. Which is the same thing, really. Nice, 9, that orc's gone. Droba hit for 3 and then 4. And missing. Gonna move on over. Change targets. These guys in the back hardly hit anyway, though. Their attack is not so great. Ow, Droba hit for 12. I really don't want the dog to get hit. I'm afraid if I put him in the middle, he's gonna attack him. Let's just keep it like this. This one's probably almost dead. Move him over, get him ready. He's hit for 2. He is hitting him. Oh, he's down. Nice. Okay, we got 1 left. I wish my character would start having a purpose in life. Other than just healing people with potions. Oh, he's running. never know. Could happen. Probably just wasting ammo at this point. Fled. I didn't even see the experience. I just spread evenly. That's a spread evenly thing. I should probably hit that every time. I don't know. Okay, so we don't have a second row. So Droba hit even though he's blind. So that is our answer there. I have no slots open. So where the dog can't carry anything, damn it. The only thing I can do is collect our torches, and that's not gonna make much of a difference. Plus, if I was able to memorize my spells, I would have slots open. Who's got the key to the guild key? Yeah. Alright, that's it. I regret that I cannot take any of this stuff. How sad. Should we heal up a little bit? 4 rations, 4, 7, 0, 1, and 3. Who's got 0? Trazric. Let's rest 3. It for us. Saving. Okay, that's it for that. Okay, I guess this is going to be the teleport back. I still don't know who founded this guild. I guess we might have to get past the undead things. It probably opens up and the guild is in there. Unless it says something about the Grey Wizards, the founder of the Grey Wizards, unless it says something in the novella, I will check that out. I'm not going to check a walkthrough to find out the name, that's cheating. Tempted, but I'm sure we could find out the name from somewhere. So, stand by, I'm going to check the novella in the back of the manual. Un momento. Okay, I forgot to pause, so I ended up using up a torch. I'm not sure if any of these are the founders, but we might as well give them a try. What is the name of the guild's founder? I would love to tell you. What is this? The ear? Oh, is to say it again? Yeah. I know it's not Casimir. Okay. Grandmaster Cantuon is from the Tower of the Seekers. That was not the correct answer. How about Mandex, who is the king's advisor? Not the correct answer. I doubt it's this Xanthi. Just a master. No. Lathias is the one who brought Tarbos to the Tower of the Seekers. Not the correct answer. The only other one I have to do this is this. I know this can't be it. Milne, who is the king's daughter from back then. Not the correct answer, so I guess we find it further down. We have to fight those undeads. Maybe we need to use those wands and stuff. Maybe we need to use blunt weapons. Casimir was not the correct answer. Marillion was not the correct answer. Marillion's a paladin or paladin. Bela and Gala are gods. Mira is the herb lady. Chandra. I do not know the answer. I think I might try again. It's gotta be up here, past this. The only thing is, once you get to this area, well, this is a dead end. The mummies and skeletons, it's two mummies and four skeletons, I'm pretty sure, are right here. Once they see you, they will follow you, keeping right up with you. So there's really no way past them, unless you try to flee, but you probably just end up going this way again anyway. I don't think you could flee past them. I think you flee back the way you came. It would make sense. Also, I'm wondering if any of us need to level up. Let me check on that. Hold on a second. Okay. So, Amethyst can level up to 3. Silk can level to 5. And Gribben can level to 5. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to level all these guys up. I'm going to put, for Amethyst, I'm going to put points into spell reading and spell using. Whatever it is called. Read magic, scroll, and use magic. I'm going to put all my points between those two. Silk, this time, I'm going to put it all into attack and parry for this time. Even though these suck, I really want these higher. But he needs to be able to hit more often, I think. And Gribben, I'm putting all into attack and parry. I'll worry about read magic scroll and use magic next time. So I'm going to put it all into attack for him as well. And we'll heal our various afflictions. And we'll come back and we'll fight those undead things. And hopefully we will prevail. So, see you guys next episode. I'll see you back at the various guilds and then we'll come back here. Thanks for watching, guys. See you next time. And always, seek adventure.